I want to know when to start counting days past ovulation.
That would be on the day you ovulate.
I do not know when to start counting that.
If you are absolutely average, that would be day 14 of a 28-day cycle.
If I start counting based on that average, I could be way off. I know some women ovulate on day 10 while others are closer to day 20.
The typical woman ovulates halfway through her cycle, no matter how long it is. So if your period is 24 days, you'd ovulate around day 12, while a 34-day cycle usually ovulates around day 17.
Even if I use the date in the middle of my cycle, that's a theoretical.
So use an ovulation test and document the day when the test says your luteinizing hormone shows up. The day it peaks is the day before you ovulate, since that hormone is what tells the ovaries to release the egg.
That's about as hit and miss as using the basal body temperature chart.
Actually, the ovulation test tells you the day before you ovulate, whereas the basal body temperature spike the day after you ovulate. Have sex when the BBT spikes, and you are too late.
Then I can use the date the basal body temperature spikes in this month to know which day I'll ovulate next month.
Many women track the changes in their cervical mucus to track fertility. When it shifts from white and gooey to clear and watery, your body is ovulating.
It changes to that consistency to give sperm an open door.
Yes, and when you see the cervical mucus take on the consistency of off-white lotion, you should start having sex to maximize fertility.
Should I start tracking ovulation from that point?
The next day, it is clear and watery, so track ovulation from that date. The next day, it is back to the consistency of lotion and the end of your fertile period.
What causes the consistency changes?
The hormone levels that spike around the time of ovulation.
But unlike luteinizing hormones, that can spike for other reasons.
But unlike the stories, no estrogen won't spike because you start feeling your biological clock ticking, really wanting to have a baby.
It won't spike because I see shoes on sale either.
Some women do feel it whinge or pain when they ovulate, and if you have that tendency, you could use that as an indicator of ovulation.
I'm glad I'm part of the 80% that doesn't have a little pain when ovulating. PMS is bad enough as is.